Hans, welcome to NSSBBMGS5. Oh, no, I fucked it up. I'm doing it again. Hans, welcome to NSSBBOTFMGS5TPP.
Did you say OTF?
Yeah. Okay. Not so Super Smash Bros. On the fence of Metal Gear Solid 5, the Phantom Thing.
Do you want to take a third
Fucker and fuck it that.
Do you want to take a third take?
No, I'm good. Let's go.
Yes, this is On the Fence, the show that helps you decide whether or not to spend your hard-earned money on the biggest and possibly best. That's some serious field of depth. But yes, the long-awaited. What the fuck? Are you playing Camera Simulator? Go do some stealth and watch some cutscenes.
I'm letting you do your spiel.
Oh god, I'm gonna vomit. Oh, it wouldn't be a Bash Bros without a bit of bodily fluids being chucked about. Yes, we're back! Better than ever!
It's my time! And my arm came off!
I'm coming! Not in the sexual way, but in the forward progress way. Big release!
Biggest release!
Metal Gear Solid 5.
Fuck. Yeah!
The cutscene simulator of video games.
This one is not as bad.
That is good to hear.
Hans, we've done a Metal Gear game on this. We played Metal Gear Solid 1. It was awesome.
I'll split the difference with you.
Do you want to hear something amazing?
Would you like to hear something amazing?
There is no codec in this game.
Wow.
And do you hear that my helicopter plays Ride the Valkyries when I land?
Oh yeah, so it does. Why are they saluting you?
Because this is me base. And look! Puffy!
The second's just here right in the mouth.
Puppy!
Can you do anything with them? No, no shit!
I can trunk the puppy.
Oh, no! Puppy! Oh, Jesus. Oh! Nick! Why have you just... What is going on? Oh, they don't give a shit. What?
What? Big Boss don't give a fuck! Big Boss a man in the air!
Staff morale increased.
Yeah!
Taking the piss.
They are thankful to see the master of CQC.
Right, I think you need...
We've gotten completely off track already.
I feel like you need to explain a lot about what has happened. Oh no, this is...
Let's go!
This is the most unstructured on the fence.
This is a long drive, so I can explain.
Okay, right.
Okay.
Wait, that's not where your marker was telling you to go, was it?
No. So Hans, would you like me to explain the backstory of this game?
In the briefest way possible.
Big Boss was a character only talked about in MGS1.
Yes.
You now play as Big Boss in the third game? Third/fourth game of his, where he is the main character.
So you play as him in 2 and 3.
You play as him in 3. Peace Walker and the prequel to MGS 5
Ground Zeroes. Demo. The 40 pound demo.
That's
30. That's fine, maybe it's $40.
So, Big Boss just woke up from being in a coma for 9 years through the events at the end of Ground Zeroes. He's pissed and wants revenge. He also has a sick prosthetic arm.
The end of Ground Zero was the helicopter exploding.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. Oh, your head went through the wall. And why is it raining now?
Okay. Chicken.
What the fuck you call me?
Essentially, this is my mother. This is the metagame behind the main gameplay of Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain.
Okay.
So, in this, you are essentially going out on mission. It's not really one massive structured, like, linear world, so to say.
Yeah.
Like, it's similar to, I've found out it's similar to The Witcher, where, like, it's not one big massive open world, so to say. It's
several hub worlds.
It's several like big massive open areas. Yeah, so but those like, are massive open areas.
It's like a lot like what a lot of new gen games are doing. Like Dragon Age Inquisition did it. The Witcher 3 did it. It's like several open worlds.
Several smaller open worlds rather than one big massive one.
Yeah, which is still cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you're essentially from here. If I bring up my iDroid.
Not even going to comment on that.
I have missions. I have only unlocked the first area at the minute. Is in Afghanistan.
Okay.
So these are missions I can go do. And these are the main story missions. And then these are the side ops, which are kind of smaller, less involved missions.
Right.
This game is laid out weirdly.
Okay. So it's not well structured?
No, it's laid out in a typical Kojima way. So like every time you go on one of those main missions, it opens up like it's a TV series. And has like opening credits saying like, oh, starring Venom Snake, Kazuhiro Miller.
We're trying to run that guy over, so I'll run him over.
Oh, I killed him.
Jesus, Nick!
Maybe you're not the big boss we hope for.
Fuck you, fuck you, Troy Baker, Ocelot.
This is still very loud. Never mind, we're good. Well,
so,
tell me more. Like, does he have a car?
No, but I got the sick ass plate. Let's go do a mission.
Yeah.
But that basically, you are getting. This was very similar to the thing that was in Peace Walker, where you were building up your own base.
Because this is essentially the start of Foxhound, this, right?
This is the start of Outer Haven.
Okay.
So, you can do here, which like, you can start building new platforms. So, I have a couple of platforms, and some are being made at the minute. And then.
What does each platform do?
They basically increased, like, so, like, I have a R&D platform, which means all my research and development, we'll get to in a second.
Crane!
Would go faster. My base development means this will mean I can build other platforms faster. This means I get better support when I'm out in the field. This means I get better intel while I'm out. This means the soldiers I send out in missions get healed faster and such.
Okay.
So, in addition to that, this is also very similar to what was in Peace Walker, project. Where you build basically new weapons rather than just find them out in the field.
Yeah.
So like once I reach certain levels, like oh, I need to be R&D team level 7, and a certain GMP global military points.
Currency then?
Yeah.
Right.
Arbitrary currency. So, but like it's simple stuff, but like it's all really cool because you are now working towards a goal rather than just oh, I found this shit in the field, let's use it.
Yeah.
And I can make this sick ass phantom cigar.
Is that past time?
Yeah. And then Phantasmian. Okay. Yep. Let's go.
And does that... What the hell does Phantasmine do again?
Drugs to help me, like, react faster.
Okay. Cool. Yeah, so why are you covered in blood?
Oh, because I'm just back from a mission. And there's a shower over there if I want to.
Ah, okay. Right, go to your mission.
Hold on, give me 40 ticks.
That's cool.
Whee! Into the box.
This is so weird.
This is so Metal Gear.
This is what.
It's awesome.
So how come you got done?
Because I wasn't killing them before.
Oh, you're just rendering them unconscious.
Yeah.
Oh, good night, Irene. Oh my God.
Give us so Metal Gear.
Temporary shower unit.
Ah!
Physically and mentally refreshed. Oh, jeez.
Pick the fuck up.
Right, you're going to do a mission instead
of
cocking about.
All right,
you've done 10 minutes of cocking about and showing little to nothing of the game.
I need to call in my helicopter. Please land in Roger.
You're going to let that fall on you as well. I don't know, staff morale's got up because you docked your people out. Oh, they're back up, it's fine. Your boy is taking an awful long time. What was that? What the hell's that?
He's like covering his eyes from the wind.
Is he doing that or is he doing
that?
No,
he does that on Mike.
Ba 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 ba. What square then? Please select a landing zone. Are you doing a mission? I genuinely can't tell.
I'm away. basically, from Hover Base, you go into, like, a aerial command center, where you're just sitting on the plane, which are up. So, from there, you then pick a mission, like, you're okay, I want to go to Afghanistan, or I want to go to one of the other areas.
Hi, everybody! So how much of this have you played?
We've established a sick bay on the new medical platform. Staff who come back with wounds, diseases, or PTSD can be treated there.
Or STIs. STIs also very treatable.
Issue the construction order from your iDroid.
Okay.
So how much of this have you played thus far?
I would say about 8 to 10 hours.
Okay.
I'm about 6% complete.
Oh, how much?
6%.
Okay. I thought you said 60. That's like you're
no. Kidding. So here
but
is.
That, I assume that means not just storyline, yeah, that is like all stuff. Hundreds.
Okay, so I'll just go in the free room in Afghanistan.
Please select a mission.
Afghanistan.
Yep. Mission accepted.
Where's it?
So is this the entire map? Did you get the map off the get go?
The landing points, no. Once you explore certain areas. You get those landing points.
Alright, so we haven't really explored up north?
No, not really.
Okay.
Heading to Afghanistan.
Do people really like this game?
Yeah.
Ooh. Horsey. Why does your horse have a visor?
It's got combat gear on. Would you ever take the horse out of the combat gear?
I don't.
Bye, horse. Hi, horse. He's a pretty horse. I like him.
Why'd you get a horse?
It's a big fucking place, okay?
Why not use a bike?
I can get vehicles at home.
Yeah, but I just... What, do they airdrop the horse in?
Presumably, yeah. You got a problem with that?
I just have many, many questions. What are you doing?
Just... I'm just double checking all my equipment. That's cool. Let's go!
Deploying.
Check on!
Is that, what the, why is there a chicken?
It's my logo.
Why is your logo a chicken?
Because you start the first couple of missions you do, you always get ranked. Like, you get ranked as an animal.
Alright, and you're a chicken?
So the first couple you are chick, because obviously it's your first couple of missions.
Alright.
So you get the chicken emblem to use.
So you're a cock, is what you're saying.
No, I'm a chick.
You're a cock.
You can get a chicken.
I'm a chick.
Because you can get a chicken hat.
So, your cutscenes and stuff.
Of a crack sniper at large in the Afghan wilderness.
Oh,
I see we didn't have to turn on subtitles, right?
Yeah, I like set off the foreign language. That's
all. Subtitles, that shit. Very unprofessional of having subtitles on for a lesson.
Sorry, right, no.
Turn on the chicken hat.
I'll turn on the chicken hat.
Are you not a chick? Wait, that's not what I mean the animal. Not stop playing with your non-breasts.
Left behind. The Soviets have already lost.
Oh my god, what is that font? It looks like teenage girl diary font.
Ah!
Not very stealthy there, Chief.
Neither is my helicopter blaring out right of the Valkyries, to be fair.
Just shut that off!
I'm on a sneaking mission!
So do the story mission? Oh jeez, that would break someone's legs. And your horse is just there, huh? Oh, stop hurting the animals!
He's good. One main issue I have with this game.
Hurting animals? Yeah, you're a dick about it.
This horse controls like shit. Okay, the horse doesn't control like shit, but like he'll do his animate, like his jump animation, like, oh, I'm gonna jump over this thing for like any tiny rock in the road, and it's really jarring. Yeah. Especially coming off like, say, like The Witcher, which actually helped the horse control.
No, it did not. Roach was a piece of crap.
Hey, what do I wanna do?
I don't know. He's
telling me.
Wait, are you out there to move?
Secure the stun. Ooh. What am I near?
I don't know. You tell me.
Marker placed.
Marker, I like her voice. Is that your girl?
What?
Your Chinese Mei Ling.
No.
No.
She's probably. No, she's probably. No, she would be born.
She'd be born. She'd be very
young. No, because she's only like 16 at the start of.
Why the fuck do they have a 16 year old operator? Or chief of communications? That's fucking idiotic.
that camera shake is makes it feel like there's like a tank or something coming. It looks pretty.
It's very fucking nice looking, yeah.
Yeah, that's getting annoying though.
Good job, Keithor.
Yeah.
They couldn't get him then to record multiple things.
So are you gonna go stealthily?
So this is like the main. This is very Far Cry-esque, I think. Like the now like infiltration stuff. Like you want to try and get like a vantage point, mark your people so you know where they're all coming from.
But is it like Far Cry where the minute you get a sniper rifle with a stealth scope, people may as well just start lying down and biting the curve for you?
Oh, why is there a horse on the road?
What the fuck you said to me? Oh. I thought your horse was gonna go for him though.
So did I.
You can't see.
So you just gotta blow up the barrels.
Can I get close enough?
No.
I was gonna try to see if I can get close enough to jump on the back of the truck. See where it takes me. Biggest change I think in this one has been like the lack of a minimap.
I suppose, but very few third-person games now have minimaps.
Yeah.
Unless they're RPGs, in which case, yeah. Z Z Z Z.
I tranked him.
Yo, I got that. He's turning around. He's going to see you. So what was that? Why'd I go slow-mo?
That's my bionic arm, like enhanced melee.
What, it makes you go slow motion?
Oh no, that was just it. That's reflex mode. So like, I'll show you here in a much more like obvious way. If I just run up to this guy and he spots me, the game goes slow-mo to give you a chance to pull out your weapon. Frank him.
And do something about it
before he actually alerts anyone.
So what's the L2 thing? Is that just
L2, if you... That's your look down sight, so if you pull that, it'll instantly snap to the guy who's actually seen you.
That's not bad, but I feel like would that make it... That'd make it pretty easy.
Yeah, but you can turn it like... It is, you can turn it off and all, and you can't get the match rank while it's on and stuff like that.
Where are your friends?
The map has been updated.
Oh, this got the Taz mission in!
Choke this motherfucker
back on!
Around.
Back on! Right, so what is the thing you're doing right now?
This is just free room, so I can just run around and do whatever the fuck I want in this area.
Yeah, but I thought you put on a map to go to somewhere.
I did, but it was all the way across that mountain. I didn't know how to get
very
there.
Very unstructured, Nick.
Is this... Yeah, it's okay. This path leads to, doesn't it? Yeah. If I go... left. Whichever way D-horse is. And that's fucking on the mountain, that's why.
How do you get up the mountain?
I don't know. I don't know if I get on the mountain.
Marker placed. Marker removed.
Yo, D-horse. D stands for diamond, by the way.
Why?
Because we are the Diamond Dogs. That's the name of the organization.
I thought it was supposed to be...
It hasn't become Outer Heaven yet. Outer Heaven yet.
That seemed unnecessarily cinematic.
This is Metal Gear.
Well, I get that, but... That would not be very helpful if you're like in the middle of a big chase or getting shot at. For it to pull this like... Close, like mid-shot, over the shoulder look. Yeah, it actually go up that way. Left.
Oh. Should say I've entered the area for
it. It did just say.
That means there should be...
Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated.
Yo, horse, stop. Come on.
Snipe that fuck!
I'm worried if it had a silent sniper, but I don't.
But you're far enough, I think.
Check the wandering mother base soldiers. There's gonna be wandering soldiers about somewhere.
I bet you they're up there. Did you really get out in your horse? Cause then like, oh, maybe don't ride towards the edge of the cliff. Why because you keep flailing yourself to the ground gaily?
Because you move so awesomely in this, I think. I like, compared to like how all the other Metal Gear games have always controlled, this one feels so fluid.
But it looks like you're trying to impregnate Mother Earth.
Because like, I could be running here and then a guy could spot me and I could go, oh shit! Whoa!
It looks like you're humping the ground.
Where are these fuckers?
You were up them, and then you fucking came down here.
Enemy predicted. Didn't say I was up.
What?
You know the thing I wish this had? Jump button.
Is there one of those things where you can?
You can walk up the stuff. It's just. It's very pernickety about the ones you can, the ones you can't. Like, there are times where I've like walked up the things and felt like I should be able to jump up them.
Especially since you're like one of the most elite soldiers ever.
Yeah.
Don't go down, go up. Because you can. It's easier to go up to the top, look down, and find them than go.
I can't walk up that cliff. I can't Skyrim my way up this.
Look at your map. Map. See, you walked through it, so. They're there somewhere.
Am I in that, like, enemy zone?
The enemy zone.
I wonder why it says there's enemies here.
Probably further into the circle. Don't go down. I'll kill you if you go down. They're going to be at the other side of the circle, which is around the ridge. Looking for something that can't be found. Welcome to Madeleine McCann Simulator 2015. Does that have a motor?
What?
Go across to the right.
Yeah, mortar.
Oh, good damn.
A Soviet soldier. A lot of them came from Central Asia before, but lately they've been using more and more Russians. Simple, really. There's less hesitation to pull the trigger if they're not fighting their own race.
Morbid. Why did you just start with one of those?
That's humanity for you.
Because they can be very difficult. Actually, hold on.
Please select a mission. Mission accepted.
I'm just gonna replay my old mission.
Let's do that!
Because this one actually, if I can get to the end of this one quickly, it actually ends in a really awesome way. D-Horse! He's a horse.
So what are buddies?
Basically, you can have, like, D-Horse is a buddy. Throughout the game, you'll recruit different people who have, like, different effects, and you can bring them in the battle.
Is that like your girl?
It's quiet.
Right, yeah, I was gonna call it Whisper, but yeah.
The sniper, yeah. Apparently, you can get Hideo Kojima as a buddy.
Surprised Konami didn't erase that one.
So this is the first mission you do after the opening in the hospital.
Okay.
Where you wake up from your coma and shit just gets fucking batshit insane in about 2 seconds.
So is there dynamic weather like sandstorms and stuff in it? Yeah.
I've seen sandstorms, I've seen rain, I've seen cloud.
You see rain, you're in Afghanistan.
I sure saw rain on Mother Base, just there now.
The area ahead is under total Soviet control.
So is this before Ocelot Revolver turns evil?
10 days.
Well, his rule's kind of always up in the air. You never really know who he's siding with.
I suppose he's only really evil to Solid Snake, not the Big Boss, because he's partners with Big Boss.
Him and Big Boss are like best friends.
Look at that horse booty.
They mocap that horse. See, this is the kind of stuff I'm talking about. You get these way fucking.
Yeah.
And they'd even, like, if it's like the first time, it says, like, introducing and stuff.
Shakalaska?
Chalashaska. Sure, he said that in Metal Gear Solid 1.
Did he?
He gets called Chalashaska. Guess Stark! What the fuck? This game is weird.
Say that's a bit of a helicopter in his head or something.
I think it's someone's bone. They're not really clear about that.
Right, okay.
He has a piece of someone's bone lodged in his head.
solo infiltration of the Soviet main ground forces.
Wow, what a schnoz.
Should be the perfect...
Was not did not think Ocelot Revolver had that big of, nose. You could hurt someone with... Is that how I saw it? Is that how Big Boss lost his eye? With a kissing? He just went, oh, no!
Miller is being held in Darwin Dehar to the north. Check its location now. Take out your eye droid.
Keith Sutherland has said very little thus far.
Yeah.
Only problem like, is we don't know his exact.
A lot of people were very apprehensive about it, like saying, "Oh, this is gonna be. He's apparently he's just so expensive, so Marker like, it's gonna be shit." So, because obviously, a lot of the appeal of Metal Gear is like the random banter between Snake and his compatriots.
Right.
Yeah. Why doesn't he say anything?
Because apparently he's very expensive to get in the booth. So.
A little to the left.
Oh, where do you want to look? Oh, there.
All right, that's the village. If you see something through the
But I haven't actually had an issue with it. Like, it makes sense that Big Boss, after all the shit he's been through,
doesn't crack
like isn't going to be some wisecracking, flirtatious guy like Solid Snake was in the very beginning. Like, this is a man who's been betrayed by his country, lost the woman he loves, and betrayed by more or less every single one of his friends. It makes sense that like he only talks to say.
But you
like, so you don't lose track I hit my life and want to die, essentially.
But yeah, he goes and clones himself.
No, he doesn't. That's completely against his will.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah.
Use your binoculars to focus in on Daviolo Calais Village and mark it.
Welcome to tutorial, bros. Use left stick to walk forward. Use right stick to rotate camera.
Wrong target, boss. Use your binoculars.
See,
to focus
this is what happened, Hans, and I have to talk.
Village and market.
Oh god, village. Village.
Good. Now you won't have to worry about getting lost along the way. He can't have much left in him. I give him 3 days, tops.
Troy Baker does a good job as Ocelot.
He always does. Troy Baker's fantastic.
We lose our chance of revenge.
Not a glorious a mustache as he has in.
Just go charging into Doan Dehar, you'll be putting both your lives at risk. See what you can find out first. The Soviets have other outposts, not just the one you saw. Afghanistan.
He also
place.
Really does look like a cowboy now that he's riding
the
horse.
I'm quite familiar with those binoculars.
He looks like an old John Marston from Red Dead Redemption.
How and where you make it, well, that's up to you. From here on out. You're on your own.
I'm always on my own. I hate my life.
You're a legend in the eyes of those who live on
trailer the quote.
This entire bit from the very first trailer.
This mission yourself.
Like right when you like it cuts out that like bit where you're on the binoculars, but like.
And return is Big Boss.
Is he not already Big Boss? Cause
he is, but everyone thinks he's dead.
Ah.
I'll be sending additional intel by radio. Stay sharp.
Stay frosty.
Bodyguard survived.
Wait, is Miller dead?
No.
Okay.
All we found
nothing
on the scene.
This is the mission to go rescue Miller.
And these.
Sick sunglasses.
You'll be missing them. And you're his only hope of getting.
I thought those were for him, and he was gonna be like, "Are you taking the piss? Do you not see the eye patch?"
What's he walking back?
He actually looks like Troy Baker.
Let the legend come back to life.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeehaw!
It's kind of undramatic when he does that. He just stands there for another second. Use the clitoris to view your controls, Nick.
Have it.
Clitoris. I am Clitoris.
What do you do? I wonder if I can just like hightail straight to the living room houses.
Why do you know where he is?
Yeah, he's at that yellow mark. The whole point of going to that first one is to like learn out, because it's quite a big complex type like area.
Oh, so it's to find out where he's being held.
Yeah,
where
he's actually being held.
It's a Soviet guard post.
No, there isn't.
They're bound to be guards. Take a look with your binoculars.
What do you want, Slot? I do what I want!
1,000 meters away. That's fine. You got it. Good diamond horse.
See what I mean? Where he kind of like jumps really weirdly.
Yeah. By the way, in the latest episode of Tales of Borderlands, there is a diamond horse.
Yeah.
And you can shoot it, and it bleeds. So there's actually a horse in the diamond. Expansion complete.
It's an enemy guard post. Watch yourself.
Is that a joke about me missing an eye? This shit's getting old. Has been updated.
That's marking. Focus on a thread and it'll be marked automatically. You can mark enemies in
vehicles. So this is essentially the tutorial though, right?
Yeah, this is like your very first mission in the open world.
You'll also see their positions on the map.
So how are you going to approach this? Give me a tactic, Nick.
Well, I'm hoping to take out this guy first.
Maybe don't. That's you missed.
Yeah, it's really weird.
You missed again. You are a terrible big boss. Oh my god.
You, there we go.
Don't leave bodies out in the open. Find some place to drop them out of sight.
So why are you going non-lethal?
If someone finds a body, they're not going to instantly raise an alarm if they're sleeping.
But if they're dead, they'll...
Yeah, they'll be like, oh shit, he's dead. Fuck. if he's sleeping, chances are they'll just come over and kick him awake.
Where is he?
Wait, why are you calling the horse?
I didn't.
Oh, I thought you were calling the horse.
That's just your contact menu.
Alright. Guard post captured. So what? Are those med kits?
These are resources you can send back to Mother Base. You can like build new platforms.
Alright, okay. So can you just do that? If you need resources...
Actually, I'll show you everything here. I wonder if it'll actually let me do it this, because since I'm going back and replaying this. To get stuff back to Mother Base, you stick it on a parachute. So if I just walk out, I just clamp a parachute to this guy, and whee!
Can you do it on live, people?
No.
Oh, what's that? Can you imagine, like, just the guard there just clicking on, it's like, bang!
I want to say maybe that is an upgrade, but I'm not entirely sure.
Glad you'd be able to if they were, like, but the, as long as you hadn't, like, alerted them.
The best thing, you can do the animals as well. So I find a goat and took it back, and then... I may have encountered a bear and vaulted them back.
How did you vault the bear back?
I
trank it and then...
Yeah, I tranked it. It took about 16 trank darts to take a bear down.
That doesn't surprise me at the slightest. So what do the soldiers do if you send them back?
They can be assigned to the different teams.
Okay, right.
So and then like they'll all have their own like strengths and weaknesses. Yeah. So like, oh, he'll be really, really good at R&D, so stick him on the R&D team.
Right, okay. I think you do know which building he's in this complex.
Vaguely. But if I don't, I can just... if I interrogate someone, they'll probably... Like, the first person I interrogate will probably say it was a prisoner too.
You've reached one day. Miller's being held somewhere in that town.
There are too many voices happening right now. You can keep gathering intel. Your sat nav lady needs to shut the fuck up. Is there a limit to the number of people you can tag?
Nope. And they stay tagged as well. Like, and up to like a massive distance. Especially vehicles, they'll still, like, stay tagged for like forever.
How many vehicles have you encountered thus far?
Quite a few. Like, none like combat vehicle. Like, I haven't seen a tank or anything.
Have you seen a Metal Gear yet?
I think so.
Ah, well, that's weird.
It wasn't really... I just saw an arm.
Was it attached to the Metal Gear, or was it being, like, developed?
I don't know. It came and picked me up.
It's cool that it'll flash which person has seen you.
Yeah.
Sneak, 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 sneak. Run, 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 run. Oh, yeah, you like that, Earth. This is essentially. Wow, there's one right there. This is very much, this is very Far Cry 3 and 4-esque. Did he come around to see where you know? Yar!
It's because he's swaying side to side and it's not fucking helping.
Oh my god!
He's swaying side to side and it's not helping matters.
Obviously, that eye patch does fucking hinder your depth perception, Nick. Fucking ponytail wearing fuck.
In MGS 3, when you first get the eye patch in first person mode, whenever you try to look down in first person, it actually like blanks out like most of your screen.
Whenever you look down at it?
Whenever you like first person aim.
Okay, you hit him, but didn't hit him. Assume you can still hit them in the stomach if you want, and it'll just
yeah, it'll just take him out.
One of your boys saw that and did not like it. Would you rather have Kiefer Sutherland or what about
David Hayter?
No. Christian Bale doing the Batman voice. Would you like that?
I think Kiefer Sutherland, like, as little as he does talk, I actually think he does a fantastic job as Snake.
Yeah, like, I mean, like, his character in 24...
It's not completely on some of the list.
Yeah, like, you know, he interrogates people a lot in that show, from what I know. So yeah, like, it's an apt comparison. It does feel unnecessary. Like, why not just have Hayter come back, you know? Where is she?
That's not what I wanted to know.
Kill him.
Tell me what I know.
I mean, want what? To know.
Sorry, I was drinking.
What do I know?
What is life?
You only have 8 darts left, by the way. From your constant missing. Click, click.
What's up, Miller?
How wick would you feel if it was randomly generated where it was?
You I think it is. Gosh. I don't think he was in there before. That was. I didn't realize he was in that building when I went in.
Gus, it's me.
Oh, wait, is he missing an eye?
Snake. No.
Or is that just beat up?
Yeah, he's beat the fuck.
They do something to your eyes. No, it's. It's just bright as hell.
So, this is the guy that Liquid is pretending to be?
Yeah.
In one.
I got that much. I remember who Miller is.
This is my favorite bit. The way everyone always gets like a title card when they're introduced.
Yeah.
He doesn't get his until he puts glasses on here. It's usually the first time like they say something, like it says it. His only fear now when he put the glasses on.
What took you so long? We'll talk about that here.
No, I didn't do it there. Maybe it's because I'm replaying it. Maybe it doesn't show.
Sure.
Attitude adjustment!
I did not know he had an arm missing.
He has an arm and a leg missing.
Did not know that. Make your way to the how did Master Miller teach a dude how to fight then? If Master Miller gonna teach Nick how to fight?
Jesus, Nick!
Did not mean to do that.
Oh, the man has an arm and a leg missing. Why
I'm sorry. I'm
that?
Sorry. I'm sorry. That's one thing I've noticed in this. The triggers are very sensitive. Slowed you down one bit. Like it takes like.
You know what else is sensitive? A stump where your leg and arm used to be.
Like, it takes no pressure whatsoever to actually, like, make it,
like, right.
Aim down sights or whatever.
In all seriousness, though, why does Miller not teach Snake how to fight and stuff? So
because he's a commander. He doesn't necessarily...
I thought you still kind of need to show him how to do it.
Yeah.
Remember, he didn't knock them both.
Do you fight my chunk? Oh, oh.
That's a really good piece of dialogue. Cause in any like Metal Gear trailer, like the first thing Snake always says is,
"Oh, kept you waiting, huh?"
He's just like, "Dude, say it. Say it a lot."
We lost it all that day.
So I take it has the look ahead. Base gone to alert status? What it said, yeah.
Yeah.
So they know they're mastering alert. It's gone, right? Okay.
So this is the bit, this is what I wanted to show you, this is the skip bit after that. because...
Wait, is it getting Sam's sweat? Is it getting Sam's sweat?
No, it's not.
Yes, it is! Look up!
Oh, it's missed. This is the introduction of, like, the evil group, so to say, and then, like, your foxhole interior.
Right.
Beating the beast, you know?
That's yours, isn't it?
Yeah. There's gas covering the
LZ. We can't land. Ha! Pulling back. Oh, okay, that's fine. Just you leave me. Dick.
It's them.
What? They look like zombies.
They remind me of the Deadly Premonition enemies.
Yeah,
because they start walking.
What the fuck is this?
Metal Gear.
Are they zombies?
I don't know. I have no
Boss,
idea.
Watch out! It's the Skulls. Don't let them find us.
Support helicopter has arrived. Whatever that mist is all around you. Horse.
Extraction. I'm changing the RV so it's outside the mist. Get over there. The chopper will be waiting.
I'm so confused.
Ditto when I first did this bit. Excuse me.
Right. Let's say it's nanomachine, shall we? Okay. Maybe it's not nanomachine. It's just magic.
Well, nanomachines wouldn't have been existed enough by now.
Okay.
Sir Naomi Hunter invented nanomachines.
Are they like jumping after you?
Yep.
Where's your health, or is it
it's kind of just leisure and strawberry jam.
Okay! Hi there, guys! Did not.
Jeep!
So, was not expecting that. Okay, you guys need to chill the fuck out.
But like, if this is some of the cool shit that's gonna happen, like, I am stoked for when the rest of the game.
Surprisingly,
this is a cool scene.
I wonder if this is how you're supposed to do it, though.
It is, yeah. Because like, the way they're standing when you like, get out there.
You can't sneak past.
Yeah, you cannot sneak past them. The mist is cleared. Well, maybe you can once like you have like, some newer equipment, like, your smoke grenades and stuff, but like...
They came at us real fast in the same kind of mist. Man. Survivors from 9 years ago were wiped out in minutes. I don't know what they want, but it's them. All right. No mistake.
Put it in Miller. I mean, put Miller in.
Really just tossing him around.
Yay! There you go, play with the mist. You're gonna take him out. So we've gone from nanomachines to magic, huh?
Oh, dude, you've seen nothing yet. You've not... Until you've seen Metal Gear Solid 3, that shit's insane when you realize that nanomachines aren't a thing yet.
Yeah, you got an
Codename
S.
Octopus.
Codename Tentacle Porn. Your current heroism?
No idea what that is.
Okay.
And then you get ending credits as well, like it's a TV series.
Well, that's been our playthrough of...
I really don't know. This game is so weird.
This screams Kojima. Wow, they really blasted past Kojima there for a second. Well. Nick.
Diamond Dogs.
Old Mother Biss.
Ooh.
Oche Mole.
Because they all get, like, foxhound-style names. That's where I so, like, it's all now. Homing pigeon.
Yeah, I knew you were going to say that.
That was some operation we had, huh? 9 years ago. Carving out our own world. Making our own future. And they took it away.
Whoa, why? What's happening? Is that why you said this is the scariest one?
Dunno.
together.
It's definitely the darkest Metal Gear. Like, it's like there's little to no like wisecracking and crap in it.
But you said it's the scariest is because of those skulls things.
Did I say it was the scariest?
Yeah, we were dogs, all right.
I feel like you did, yeah, earlier. When we were sitting watching
digging up whatever kind of dirty money we could find. You name it, we did it. You see this?
This is a screaming sexual.
Our new home. A phantom of our former selves. Triumph. Death.
This is the one issue I have with Kiefer. Obviously because they maybe didn't get him in enough because he was so expensive.
Yeah.
You get a lot of these like one-way conversations happening. I remember. Where like everyone's kind of just monologuing towards Snake.
Yeah.
Rather than having a conversation with him.
But at the same time, like, the writing's good enough that
it carries it.
Yeah. Like the dialogue, it's quite hard to write a monologue, but if it's done well, it's quite enjoyable, and so far it has been quite good.
Like, the kind of only like funny bits have been around when you first get the dog watching Ocelot try to train it. And then Snake makes a joke about a cat training a dog.
Hey. Is this the mission 9 years ago?
Yeah, this is the end of the original. Where like the original mother base was destroyed.
Just like a damn fiddle!
Help me, Snake.
Is this skull face?
It all ends soon, exactly as I planned.
No!
Get a bomb, Virginia.
Yeah, no, because, like, I remember reading, like, she had two bombs in her.
Yeah, one in her stomach.
And then like they get like, yeah, we got the other bomb. She's like, no, there's another one. You're like, oh, right. So what was the point in making us sit there and watch through one fucking horrific scene about pulling a bomb out of a girl's chest? Why was it in her vagina? Why'd she have a snook in her sniz? Because Kojima.
Yeah.
Nick.
Hans. Snake.
If I was on the fence. You could do stuff if you want. If I was on the fence about Metal Gear Solid Please 5, a landing zone. Heading to what would you tell me?
I would say, first off, at the minute, I do not feel like you've needed any prior knowledge of Metal Gear to enjoy this. They actually do a really good job of explaining what you need to know to understand the story of this one. Like, I doubt they'll go into a lot of the deeper shit. But they go into the stuff you need to know to get an understanding of the story of this one.
So it's a bit like Witcher 3 that way.
Yeah. Gameplay-wise, it's the best playing Metal Gear game. By a fucking country mile.
But it also seems very different to past Metal Gear games. Yeah. So will die-hard Metal Gear fans not like it as much?
It doesn't play as differently from 4. Like, 4 was a lot more like a third-person shooter than the other ones were.
Okay.
But, like, this is shaping up to be just free gameplay wise, free, like, the massive tonal shift, making it a much more serious story. But you can still do dumb shit, like, have Ride of the Valkyries play while you fucking land in your helicopter and then jump out of the helicopter and trank a dog.
Welcome back.
I love how you were able to trank that dog as you jumped out of the helicopter but could not hit a standing enemy.
Because I wanted to try and hit the. I can hit the dog anywhere and he goes down.
Don't have enough medicinal
plants. I wonder. I'm gonna do something here. It might break it. The recording. Or well, it might not record this bit, but it should, because it'll just see the things. So I wanna go show my. That's the wrong way to do it. But I wanna go to show you my gallery, because I took a screenshot of. Where is it? Can you remember how to see all your stuff?
Library.
Where's the library? That's in like Share Factory, isn't it?
No, it's Capture Library at the very back.
Capture Gallery. I took a picture of me Fultoning the bear.
Okay. Very. It looks like it's looking at you like,
why would you do this to me?
He looks like Winnie the Pooh when he gets trapped on the balloon.
But yeah.
Bye-bye. Right. So that's a big Resign Dane thumbs up from Nick then, yeah?
Ah! Massive thumbs up. This is...
Just leave it on. Just leave it on this.
It's shaping up to be the best Metal Gear game. And, like, not even just the best Metal Gear game. It's shaping up to probably be one of the best third-person action games.
What about... Would you call it a Game of the Year candidate?
Most definitely.
Or Witcher 3, Nick?
Yeah, and obviously, I'm still really early on in this. Like, I've played, like, near 10 hours, and I'm only, like, 6% through.
Mm.
So I've heard people playing it for about 60 hours and being only having, like, finishing the main story, but only being about 50% done. So, like, if this keeps, keeps going with the momentum it has, I would say this probably easily surpasses The Witcher 3 for me.
Sweet. So there you go. Hopefully we have shown you enough to let you know. Puppy, no. Put it back. Nick.
Papa.
Nick. Put it back. Nick. This is why you don't have more friends.